Handphone ni buka balik eh. Buka balik. Okay, eh. So they have to this apa the in the regulation is stipulated that they must have if the numbers of the worker less than 100, it must be two representative, and if more than 100, it must not less than four representative each from the employees and also management. Yeah. So the company have to appoint secretary, secretary of the committee is under section 50, section 6, regulation 1996 of the Satihat Committee. And if there is person be appointed as safety officer, automatic the safety officer become the secretary. This is important because directly the health safety officer is the person responsible in managing health safety at that workplace. So appointment of other members, okay, the other employee shall invite person employed to nominate their representative to become a member of committee. If the number of persons so nominated exceed the vacancy available, a ballot shall be held to determine the representative. So employer, for example, the manager have to invite people or ada employee, pekerja tu, dia akan buka invite sesiapa yang berminat untuk become safety health committee untuk mencalonkan dirinya. Dia akan berminat, dia akan postkan untuk siapa yang berminat untuk jadi committee. Represent employee, ada pekerja, employee, so they can. So if the number exceed the vacancy available, so there has a ballot. Ballot maknanya undian. Undian dibagi undian siapa yang peminat untuk jadi safety committee boleh boleh dibuat undian pula daripada pekerja. So this is very very democratic punya process. So in case where no representative or the representative is not enough, the employer shall appoint the required number of person to present. If not enough and nobody interested, the employer can appoint. Number of person to represent. But if you work at the private sector, especially industry, the numbers people yang interested quite many, because this the experience they can gain. It's like a profile. It's like their profile. If you involved in a certain committee, it is a an advantage that you are really skillful and experienced people. This is an advantage because the demand is there. The demand is there to more health safety. You got extra knowledge and skill. An employer shall not penalize a member of committee for being absent from duties while carrying out the functions of the committee. So when they become health safety committee, they have duties to do, and they have to play their role, and the employer cannot penalize them because they carrying their duties to be functional, to be function at the committee. For example, there is a accident happened and the committee have to investigate. So the representative, the employee have to play their role, eh, helping the committee. So the employee cannot penalize, eh. So the adequate employee representative, the representatives of employee in safety and health condition shall be represent the various section. It should be, if it's good, the ideal committee, health safety committee is every section. For example, like apa ni, Sony, kan? Sony, they have different department. For example, department of making LCD, department that making a video player, eh? Video player. Department that making apa ni, fridge, kan? So every area tu, every department should represent, as a safety committee, eh? So if the vacancy occurs in safety health committee, the vacancy shall be filled with the same manner. If sometime the committee retired or resigned, eh, or didn't come 3 times, or they have suffer accident ke, or mental illness, eh, so there is a vacancy. So the process is similar in the section 7, eh, there is a there is what they call it, pengumuman, pengosongan, siapa yang nak berminat bermohon, kalau lebih kena buat ballot, eh, pilihan dan raya, eh, pemilihan, eh. So the process same, eh, in section 7. So in the committee, as member of committee in section 7, in section 10, you also, the committee also can be removed. It can be removed. If committee can be removed if they fail to attend 3 consecutive meeting without leave of the chairman. If you fail to come in the meeting without a reason, and the chairman didn't approve, you can be terminated. As a committee members of safety, and they, you can be removed. And also, if you have an unsound mind, and you have distress, mental illness, eh, suddenly you've got schizophrenia, you can be removed, eh, from the committee. And so you become bankrupt, eh? Bankrupt maksudnya hutang banyak, you tak mampu bayar hutang, dan bank bawa pergi mahkamah. Bila bawa pergi mahkamah, mahkamah luluskan, you jadi bankrupt, bankruptcy. So people yang bankrupt ni tak boleh jadi LCT committee members. So you all mesti waspada. Waspada if you just graduate, dengan pandai-pandai nak jamin orang, eh? Kalau pinjam bank kena bayar, bulan-bulan kena bayar, jangan tak bayar, eh? Bank ni lah yang paling paling bahaya kalau kita buat pinjaman, eh? Dia dapat detect, easily detect you, and you kalau apa bankrupt, habis apa-apa harta yang ada kat you, contohnya dia ada kereta, kereta akan ditarik, eh? You tak boleh beli harta, eh? Gaji you kena potong, you tak boleh pergi luar negara dan sebagainya, eh? It's a tough, become a bankruptcy people, eh? So ukur baju badan sendiri, eh? Kalau you nak beli property dan sebagainya, kalau you tak mampu, jangan nak apa beli, eh? Tiba-tiba keluar aje graduate terus beli BMW ataupun Honda, kan? Gaji RM2,500 tapi bayaran kereta RM1,800. Rumah sewa nak bayar, eh? Sampai masa you tak boleh bayar kereta, kan? Nah, apa? Banyak komitmen lain. makan pun makan Maggi tak boleh bayar kereta. Yeah? Sampai 4 bulan bank akan bawa you pergi mahkamah untuk repossess you. Repossess the car and see you apa ni buat mahkamah untuk apa bankruptkan you. Eh? Consider you as a muflis. Eh? Then there'll be a problem. And people who are no longer employed, I mean, some of the members committee are being retired, eh, pension dan sebagainya, tak bekerja lagi kat situ, tak boleh lah jadi committee, automatic can remove. Eh? Okay. And members involve fraud, dishonesty or moral turpitude, eh, involve fraud. Scammer, ingat involve scammer, eh? Dishonest, didapati tak pecah amanah, eh? Dishonesty, ada moral pula, turpitude. Moral ni contoh kaki judi, ada masalah moral, nah, eh? Gay, lesbian, itu moral turpitude, eh? Offense under law. If being convicted, for example, right now COVID PKPB, dia PKPB, dia langgar law PKPB, kena saman 1,000. Also offense, eh, under the law, you also can be removed, eh, convicted offense under law, then criminal, other criminal, eh, mencuri dan sebagainya, eh. Memperkosa, all these things, the members can be removed. Eh? Unable to discharge his duty as a member. If the members unable to discharge his duty, maksudnya, he unable to run his role as a committee, health safety committee. For example, he got accident, eh? He got paraplegia, paralyzed. So, he cannot discharge his duties, eh, because some of the function of the committee have to inspect. They need the committee need mobility. Eh? They need to walk, to climb ladders. Eh? So this person paralyzed, so he cannot discharge his duties as a member. So he can be removed from the safety committee. So this another part, they call it the function of safety and health committee. Okay. So what are the functions of safety and health committee? Another one, sorry, before that, there is a chairman. Kan? So who's the person should be the chairman? Anyone knows? Siapa chairman tu? Sepatutnya chairman tu siapa? Anyone? Amira? Farah? Semua senyap dia ni? Dengar ke? Hello?
Dengar.
Agak-agak chairman tu siapa? Tak apa, teka je. Saya nak dengar juga suara you all ni. Farah Abdul Aziz. Aizat.
Safety head officer boleh tak?
Ha? Safety head officer? Safety officer tu dah dilantik sebagai secretary. Ha, automatik dia jadi secretary. Okay, chairman should be the higher position at the company. For example, GM ke, eh? So they have authority to say, eh? Or deputy chairman ke, kan? Deputy manager, apa, general manager ke, deputy manager. So they have the one that have say lah. It's good that the chairman Because chairman ni yang akan membincangkan dan memberi maklumat pada orang yang paling tinggi sekali dalam company. Kalau dapat orang yang paling tinggi dalam that company, it's going to be good. Dia tak boleh orang biasa je jadi chairman. So, what is the role or the functions of safety committee? This is part 3. Under this safety committee, section 11, the function of the safety committee is to assist in the development of safety and health rules and safety system of work. So, in the workplace, in the organization, they have a rules and safe system of work. So they have manual, they have guideline, they have procedure. So a health safety committee assists in the development of safety and health rules and safe system of work. At the same time, they also going to review the effectiveness of the program. So program that been planned by the health safety officer or the management, they will review whether it is effective or not. When talk about effective or not, based on what? Anyone? Isaac, how we know the program is effective or not? For example, program can be training, kan? Training, education. For example, training manual handling, training program, drilling, emergency drilling. Program, for example, apa dia? Program identification of hazard. Identification of hazard. Training, for example, there is a program, medical surveillance of that. So how they know whether the program effective or not? So based on statistic. For example, safety health officer will every month will analyze the statistic in terms of accident, near miss, poisonous occurrence. For example, there is occupational diseases at the workplace based on the reporting, and also based on the survey can be done also in the survey. For example, the program, for example, manual handling program. So they want to educate their workers in terms of how to live safely of the load. So there is a pre and post survey. For example, pre and post survey. Pre, what is their knowledge and their skill before the program, training of the program, and after that they will do another survey pre and post. From that they analyze. So they actually can detect whether the program is effective or not, based on statistic. For example, accident. For example, this year, number of accident. For example, there is 3 fatal deaths, kematian, tahun 2019. Dan 2020, ada 7 kematian. It means that the program that been run at the workplace not effective. For example, like COVID-19 also. For example, you see that if they not implement PKPB, the numbers of positive COVID-19 increasing. But if they do PKPB, the number of the COVID positive reducing. And there is a figure tu, not eh, not based on not. Kalau not the 2 point and above, it shows that the program that they've been done eh, is effective. The not what below one, it means that jangkitan tu will kalau below 1 it means that jangkitan dia berkurangan. If more than 2 jangkitan dia akan bertambah. So based on the numbers of diseases eh, positive victim eh. Okay, sorry guys, sekejap lagi. Okay. So, the Statistical Committee also have to study the trend of accident, yeah, near miss accident. They have to study the trend of accident. Kalau makin meningkat, makin, I mean, dia punya program is not effective. Dia punya system is not effective. Eh? Near miss accident. Near miss apa dia? Maksudnya hampir-hampir berlaku kemalangan. So in health safety, we also take into account accident, apa, near miss accident, hampir-hampir berlaku kemalangan, eh, pun diambil kira. Katakan ada apa ni, batu blok jatuh daripada tingkat 4, tapi tak kena pada pekerja. They call it near miss accident. If there is dangerous occurrence happen, so they take into account the occupational poisoning or occupational diseases and report to the employer together with recommendation for corrective action. So they have to study the trend. Health safety committee, so yearly trend, monthly trend, eh, based on the statistic or that, then they have to come up with report and recommend for corrective action. Yeah. They have also have to review the policies and make recommendation for any revision of the policies. The company, there is a policy, yeah, policy. They have to review the policy and recommend or the for any revision based on the current situation, current trend of accident, near miss. Yeah. So they have to review the policy. And their job is another under section 12. Their job is to inspect of a place of work. So they have to do an inspection at least once in every 3 months. Eh? So at least once in every 3 months they have to do inspection. So they have to check every number 3 months once. Eh? Then they have to discuss with the committee during inspection the circumstances of the report, the detail. Okay, they have to discuss with the committee anything that have to take action. Eh? They have to record the details and make and report recommendation in a report to the employer. So every 3 months, one, at least once, they have to do the inspection. Eh? And then they have to investigate if there is an accident. If there is an accident, the committee shall inspect the place of work immediately after any accident. So when a person is employed as a safety health officer, he shall report the investigation regarding the accident to the chairman of the committee. And the chairman as soon as possible to conduct the meeting and discuss the report with the committee. So, if there is safety health officer, their safety officer have to investigate if the accident is not a major, for example, minor accident. So the chairman, the safety officer have to investigate, and then they have to report the investigation of accident to the chairman, eh? And the chairman have to conduct a meeting to discuss the report to the committee. So, is is a very important role to the health safety committee. When no safety and health officer is employed, the employer shall inform the chairman or secretary to convene a meeting to investigate such incident. If sometime there's no